and for growing is new experiences. So I would love to be able to take kids to tournaments all the time. This past July, we took, I bus out probably 150 kids to a pro tournament just north of Chicago. We were fortunate to have Tom Gullis to talk to the kids, which was awesome. But unfortunately, I can't do that all the time. So I bring the tournaments to them. So we're going to do this. So somebody give me one grand slam tournament. You name one Wimbledon. So my fun fact about where Wimbledon is the shortest player to compete was only 4'9". Pretty small, right? Okay. So this is going to be, we're going to have a Wimbledon court. What's another grand slam? French Open. The fun fact about the French Open is French toast really isn't French. Okay. Did you know that? Okay. US Open. So my fun fact for the US Open is that Arthur Ashe was the first African American to win the US Open. You knew that? Awesome. What's the last one?
Australian Open.
And the fun fact about the Australian Open is that there's 750 reptile species in Australia. Okay? So I just find facts and I bring it to them. So what we're going to do is I'm going to set four different courts. So down here, my coach Butch on the Australian Open, we're going to do champion of the court. So let's do you two playing champion of the court first, right here. Don't worry, we're going to play, everybody's going to rotate. For the French Open, okay, you're going to be with Coach Rita, and you're going to practice your lobster trap. Yeah, Coach Rita's going to help you with lobster trap. Yeah. So Coach Rita's going to talk to you, you're going to be the lobster first, so she'll help you. All right, guys, come on down. We're going to talk to Coach Paul. Thank you. you're not standing on one court all the time, you can actually help them. So again, don't put yourself on the court, keep yourself rolling.
Are you guys good over there? All right, good.
And let's keep showing that respect to those graduates, okay? All right. So that's G. That's growth. Because I wanted to see how far they come from week one to then week six sometimes. Maybe it's just a working program, but I want them to see where they have come. They love to come back and look at my phone. They love to compete with it. Sometimes I use the neighborhoods against each other, and I'll say, hey, you know, the kids did the Oakville Gardens got 150. Let's see if we can beat them. Now, sometimes I do lie a little bit, but it does work because it's, and it's quite loud. It's nothing crazy, but it just gets me excited. Again, I want to go back to your question. So even though I may have a line of kids, they're not standing in line very long because it's still a child on this side that's starting the ball. So the coaches that I work with, they don't know what feeding is. So I'm actually lucky because they think the norm is to have the kids work together, and they understand that if Deontay has to take a couple steps to get the ball, it's actually letting him work on it. I've never had one parent complain to me that their child has to move to get to the ball, or that their partner can't toss the ball directly to them. I bet if I ask some of you that work in the club, you have parents complaining about the parents tossing. I see heads nodding. I don't have that. Okay? So we definitely have kids. I sometimes have eight, but I just haven't rotated within each other. So I just want to end with two quotes from two of my kids. So the one thing is Curtis. Curtis has the most energy I've ever seen, but he's not the strongest athlete and by far not the best tennis player we have in one of our programs. He said, tennis made me believe anything is possible because I learned a new sport that I did not know when I saw the Olympics. Tennis makes me believe I can do anything now. And then Ian said, I always look forward to tennis on Fridays. It's fun, coaches are nice, I get out of the house, and it's safe. Thank you to my coaches. So it's safe. So tennis is a safe environment for a lot of these kids. And it's proven that if kids feel safe, they feel safe in their environment, they feel safe with their coaches, that they're going to be successful. And so again, because we all have the same passion, I really ask you to go back to your communities. If you're in a community, if you're in a club, and find programs that you can help, or find two kids that you can bring in, because there really shouldn't be any limitations when we're trying to change the future of our youth. So with that, I thank the players, I thank the coaches that help me, and thank you for coming.